All right, welcome back, everyone. Welcome back. This is, welcome back to another episode of The Scenic Route, Volume 2. Let's explore Botania. How are you guys doing? I hope you guys are doing all right. I'm doing just great out here. I am getting really sick of that red brick building back there. It's just, it's fine. It's serving its purpose as our starter house that we didn't have to build. Are you following me? Because I got seeds in my hand there, buddy. I expanded the garden a little bit. Just, I'm adding more. Oh, perfect. Got potatoes there. Alternating this. I wanted to get in more cotton. So we got a nice big cotton array going here. And then more. These are just literally just more carrots and potatoes. And some more wheat. So as you can see here. You can't see my mouse. Jeez. Well, as you can see at the bottom of this list, we have a stronghold temp for temporary entrance. I went ahead and went and found a stronghold just by using the Eyes of Ender, and it's way down over here. Also, look right near there. We've got a pirate ship. So I think we're gonna dust that pirate ship today. And then we're going to go in there and clear out that stronghold and get ourselves an end portal. But we're not going to take on the dragon today or anything. We have some other things to do as far as Botania goes. So the first thing is, a couple of days ago, I just went down here to our crazy dungeon. And I was like, you know what? I'd like to just clear out a little more. I just want to claim it. I want it to be safe to walk around and etc. I ended up spending 2 full days clearing this out, and at some point I got into it and I was like having fun. It was going really well. As you go down further in the levels, you do find better and better gear as you go. Nothing super, super duper overpowered, but I did find like an Unbreaking 3 book and an Efficiency 5 book down there. But yeah, it got pretty crazy. But there is a reason I went ahead and just made a bypass down here. There is a reason now I know to clear out these dungeons. So, okay, we're gonna go down there. There's some more important stuff down there, but you gotta see the extent of this thing. Oh yeah, we also are in a slime chunk, apparently. Look at this nonsense. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What is this? This is just a death chamber, right? I mean, this is just, it's just ludicrous. I'm not sure how I cleared all this. The one thing that I found very, very helpful was this deal here. Let's show you really quick. All right, so in Quark, we can have torch arrows. So I think we saw that in one of the other episodes, but torch arrows allowed me to launch an arrow into a wall and it places the torch there. Okay, this is very interesting. I have no idea what I just pushed. I'm holding zoom and it's showing me my inventory. Oh, what is this button doing? I don't know what this is. I'm pressing the X key on my keyboard. It's showing me my inventory, but I can't access it. It's just to see what's in the inventory. Oh, if I hit, oh, it changes it to your hotbar. I had no idea. I don't even know what this is. I don't know if this is from Quark. I don't know what this is from. Oh, that is super, super handy. They need this in vanilla. This needs to be a vanilla thing. This is very, very usable. This would make building very, this is very cool. How did I not know about that? How did I not know about that? Because I'm CryinMo. Yeah. Okay. We're going down here just to show you the extent of this. And look at this. It just keeps going and snaking around here. And then check this out. So right here, in this chamber, there was a thing. So remember this chamber right here. And remember CryinMo saying, there was a thing here. And we'll get back to that in just a bit. And all through here, all in these little alcoves though, there were skeleton heads. Okay, so back here to this little, central area. And we can run down here. Now, this was the, this is like the fourth level. It might be the fifth level. And it was all decorated and hanging vines and everything, and it was very cool coming through here. Lots of cool things. Again, much more cobble, a lot of mossy cobble in here. It's fantastic. So remember that other chamber I showed you, and I said something happened here? And yeah, guess what? Something happened in here too. And that's because CryinMo doesn't learn his lessons. I learned it for this. Now, you can almost see it there. You can almost see it. You can almost see it. This has probably got to be one of the coolest things. Those of you that play modded, you already know, but I had no idea. Look at that. You know what that is. That is a creeper spawner. Never have I seen such a thing. Never, never, never. But how awesome is that? So, yes, my first two things that happened were other creeper spawners, and apparently in the creeper spawner rooms, yes, you have creepers. You also have trap chests, and they were wired to lots and lots of TNT in both places. And, of course, in the first room, I had no idea. I didn't know what was happening. I was just so excited I found a creeper, you know, spawner, and then there was a creeper next to me, and it blew up, and it blew everything up, and it blew me up. And then the second time I found one of these, I was very careful. I was very careful the second time I found one of these. And I cleared the room, I lit it up, and then I opened a trap chest. Here's what's doubly dumb about CryinMo here. In my texture pack, I have trap chests colored differently than regular chests. Here, though, I was very careful and I preserved it. And guess what? We're gonna have a creeper farm. It's pretty awesome. Meaning, we have a gunpowder farm is what we've got there. Now, further on into the depths of clearing out this area, I came down this way, and look at that room there. That's pretty interesting. Look at this. Look at that. Hello, Mr. Enderman spawner. Hello. So, I don't even know if we need to go to the end to make an Enderman farm, except I don't actually know. The problem with this is, I don't know what to do with this. The problem with this guy is I don't think we can make a farm with this because we are at level 20. You have to drop Enderman like 42 blocks to get them to one health, I think, or maybe 32. It's a lot more than 20, that's for sure. And of course, there's bedrock down there, so we only have about 15 blocks, and we can't pipe. There's no way to transport Enderman. So, I mean, obviously, we could make a rudimentary farm where we could have them, I guess, spawn in the air, and they can fall 15 blocks into a contained area where we can kill them. Yeah, I don't know how to make use of this Enderman. I haven't thought about it yet enough. If you guys have ideas on how to make an Enderman farm out of a spawner that doesn't have enough room for them to drop, let me know. Let me know. So this goes down to the sixth level, which is all like the nethery stuff, right? And what's down here is pretty epic as well. So I came down here. I cleared it all out. There's one room. I still have not cleared out the largest chamber. But so this was the first one I came into, and you see all the dirt up there? Does that remind you of anything? There's dirt there, and in this chamber as well. Another giant dirt block. You guys know what this is, right? Yeah, can we see what's up there? Oh, you can't really tell. That's a blaze spawner. Yeah, and right over here also is another blaze spawner. More skulls. Oh, there was a particularly cool skull I was going to show you, which is, I left it so you guys could see it, because I was rather amazed. I was like, look, check this out, like that, look at that. Yes, a wither skull, man, just sitting on a shelf for us. That's crazy. So I actually believe, I think I have three of these now. I can actually, we can make a beacon, and we haven't even gone to, well, okay, that's not true. We have gone to the Nether, and I did go find Nether Fortress, but I didn't kill any, I mean, I didn't find any wither skulls there. But anyway, so yeah, this dungeon turned out to be pretty phenomenal. We do need, you know, we need shulker boxes, and we need elytra. So we put some mileage on a horse here, and we kind of came down and cleared through the middle of the map here, so everything's now dialed in here, because I had some blank areas in the middle. It wasn't too bad. I put a couple of bridges through a couple of little spots here. Just planks across the water. But I kind of came as far as we can go. And here we are in the middle of the screen by Rogue Dungeon 008. And we're going to park our horse at the edge of that beach right there. And we're going to go and assault that pirate craft. There it is. There's another one of these great dungeons here. Yeah, very cool. Okay, so there's our pirate ship right there. We're not going to take this on from the front, which would just be noble and brave and dumb. We're going to be all sly and come in like assassins here through the back of the boat. Make ourselves a little platform here. Yes. And here we go. All right, let's see. There's going to be all kinds of cool stuff. Oh, fire charges. A lot of gold. Look at that. Oh, that's yeah, okay. All right, all I want a hat out of this excursion here is what I want to make sure I get. There we go. And then we'll take this out. You see, CryinMo has learned some things from roguelike dungeons. Oh, that was a bad thing. Ah, I'm going to die again. Look at these. These guys have great textures, right? They're all sort of mossy and everything. That's really cool. I wish we could get one of their heads. Oh, I forgot I have a fire aspect on this sword. I found this sword in roguelike dungeons, actually. And I think I put it together with another one. And it is, yeah, what do we have on here? Knockback, fire aspect, ban of arthropods, and unbreaking. Yeah, well, you know, it's a tool. And just give me your hat. I just would like a hat. Can I have a hat? Nobody's given me their hat yet. I'm very disappointed. Oh, hello. All right. I did not get a hat. I am bummed. No hat for CryinMo. No pirate hat. Are you kidding me? Oh yeah, plenty of good things in here. There's a pirate hat. Thank you very much. Now I feel appropriate and I look good. Yeah, man. It was made for me. It was made for me. Oh, look at that. That's so cool. Okay, so we just have this little hidey hole here in the hillside. That's all we got here. A little bed to sleep in. Some empty chests. Not much in here. There's some more torch arrows. Okay, so let's do this. Let's do it. All right, I have no idea what's down here. We just want to find the end portal, and then we'll go do some Botania magical stuff, I think. All right, well, this was a pretty underwhelming stronghold, so I did find a few things. I kind of put some things away. This is a very small, at least it appears to be a very small stronghold. I mean, I rolled through the whole thing, and it took me literally probably 10 minutes to go through the whole thing. It seems to be tiny. I don't know. Let's see. But yeah, you go down here, there's some little side levels. They don't go anywhere. There's a room back there. There's a room over here. A couple more little short hallways, but like I just went up and over and there was another door here. Cruise down here and here is the portal room right here. So I already got it lit. I'm not going in there because I'm not prepared to go in there and fight the dragon or anything yet. And that's it. Like, that's really it. I only found two chests in here. One of them was right there. This spiral staircase right here goes down to the single library. So I'm glad there was at least a library and there were two chests in here. And I found, like, that's where one was. And I found some good books. So remember, these are our modded chests, our modded loot tables. So they're pretty high end. In that one chest upstairs, I found the emeralds and this nice axe, mending and unbreaking 3. Digging it. That's very cool. Also found golden apples and some gold. And then in the books here in the library, I found, these are all crazy good books. They're all top of the line books because that's what our, look at that, Thorns 3. I mean, these are crazy. Finally, we've got Silk Touch, though. That's literally the first thing I've had with Silk Touch. So that is a big deal. I wish I'd gotten more Silk Touches. That's a good book right there. And that's about it. Okay, so on to another topic. Check this out. I went and got string last time, right? And we had these floating guys because I wanted to see the little island lamps floating over, you know, it looked like they were just hovering over anything. But check it out. So you stick this guy on a regular block, take the block out, it floats, and the light source counts as coming from here. So I thought that was a interesting discovery. Anyway, so, okay, here we are. This is just nonsense up here. These two blocks are called open crates, and they just drop whatever goes in here. See that? And look, all of our flaming, what are these called? Endoflames are just lighting up almost all the way across. So these flowers all over here can reach that square, but these couple over here don't reach it. That's why the other one is up there. But I wanted to point out something to you guys, which is... So these crates, obviously there's no reason to use these. Oh boy, that's loud. So you can put any color wool you want, you can put onto the mana spreader, which is this block here. And that's supposed to muffle that sound. That didn't muffle the sound. I think that's actually the sound of the flowers burning, I think. Wow, it's pretty loud when we're standing at, jeez. Yeah, that's annoying. Well, anyway, I've gone through pretty much maybe a single chest full of stacks of oak logs. And look at this. Let's grab our wand of the, where's our wand? There it is. Wand of the forest. So we click on it. There's almost no mana in there because I used it all up. I used up the mana that was in there to make this mana steel and a couple of other mana items, mana glass, mana pearl. You just drop in ender pearls and you get these back. You drop in regular iron ingots and you get mana steel ingots back. This is an awesome device right here. I want to show that to you. But anyway, and this thing here, this block in the middle is just a mana distributor. So it just absorbs mana from a spreader. The spreader is picking up mana from the generating flowers. Look, the wood's already gone, right? So two stacks of wood, it's all gone already. And look how much mana, or how much mana we didn't get. Yeah, see that little tiny blue? The little tiny blue at the very left side of that bar? That's how much mana went into this pool. This one's practically empty. That one is the tiniest bit. I mean, so that was two stacks of wood, and now it's done. There's no more mana being generated. So it takes a ton of resources to generate mana. There's another type of flower we want to try out, which is the hydrangea, which is water-based. So it only lasts for one real-world hour, and then the flower will decay, but it will absorb water source blocks. Obviously, these mana pools hold a lot of mana, but the mana goes pretty quick, especially when converting items. So I don't know. I'm a little, I didn't realize we need quite that much volume of stuff. Check this out. So this is an hourglass. This is so cool. I wish this was in vanilla as well, but it's just a timer block, and it works based off how many pieces of sand you put in it. Yellow sand, regular sand, is one block equals 1 second of time in the timer. So you can totally add up how many seconds you want. So you want 1 minute, you put in 60 blocks of sand. Red sand is 10 seconds per block, and soul sand is 1 minute per block. So you can really, I mean, you could put in, I guess, up to one stack. I don't know if you can put in multiple stacks. Maybe you can, but at any rate, if you pick up you put in a stack of soul sand, that's an hour. It'll run for an hour. So when it flips, boom, we get a signal out of it. And it works with a repeater as well. So that would be something we could use here to make this timeout, and we could have items ready to go. And then it would just release a few, or just release one every so often. I'm itching to build something in the world. And I know we just haven't built anything yet because we've been doing all the just sort of exploring things. But check this out. This is the living wood block. It's called glimmering, and because I mix glowstone with the block itself, and it gives us a light level of 11, and it's pretty cool. I don't know what it looks like at night. I haven't checked it out. I'm sure it's lit up a little bit. It's probably got a faint glow to it, but this is a pretty rad block. I don't think we can do anything with this other than have full blocks. I don't believe we can make slabs or anything. No, we can't. So over here is our Nether portal, and I went ahead and just made it super tall. It's not super duper tall. I think I'll make it even taller, actually, to go up there in the hillside. And I want this. Let's decorate this and make it some kind of cool. I don't know. Let's try to make something elvish, I guess, out of it, since this is supposed to be our elven area. And then the other thing I was thinking of, as far as our building up here in the trees. I don't know. I'm thinking about building, maybe we need to build like elven houses in the trees, like elegant ornate tree houses throughout the trees or throughout the forest. And maybe they actually embed themselves partially in the trees and the leaves and stuff. So I thought that might be, I thought that was kind of cool. Dang it. Wrecking my nice ground over here. So uncalled for. We need some parrots, right? Okay, so I did a few things here. Yeah, some things I probably should have done on camera, but I didn't quite realize it was gonna take over quickly what I was doing. But so you can see, obviously, I changed the setup here. What these are the hydrangeas, and I guess they're absorbing water. I thought they were gonna make the water blocks disappear, but they don't. The water seems to stay there. So now they're gonna all start feeding this guy. But look, it's aiming like at the torch, right? So you take your wand to the forest, and we're in bind mode. I guess we can do bind. I don't think I... So we do that, and we... Oh, there we go. So then it aims there. But you can also do this. Oh, yeah. So if you keep tapping it, you can rotate this thing around and aim it in sort of weird areas. So anyway, you can do that as well, which is, I guess, easier. But I thought the idea of being able to manually direct that was pretty rad. This is what I've been working on over here. So I needed to make some more living rocks. So I just put down our pure daisies over here, top of some glimmer wood, just over here. It's just a manual process at this point. I just keep putting down stone, we can just convert it. And I just been mining it up by hand. And just to kind of try to create a store of this living rock, because it's such a cool design block. And this is what I started working on here. So our little elven portal here, obviously it's just in progress. So this is starting to look pretty good here. The pond, the aperture here is looking very nice. And but now I gotta work on this stuff on the side somehow, and somehow make this look like it's blending into the hillside here, blending into the hill, and I'm just not clear on that. Also, we need a way to be able to get out from the sides here. The one thing that I found that was kind of amazing for me to discover that doesn't exist, apparently in any mods except for some mods that work in 1.7, are buttons. Nobody makes a button. You know what I wanted on here so badly? I wanted a quartz button. Or just a white button. And you know what? They don't exist. They don't exist in Quark. They don't exist in hardly any mods. I went and searched Curse Forge, and there was two mods that had alternative buttons, but they were not for version 1.11. They were for version 1.7 and for version 1.10. So I'm going with the wood there. I did try some with the stone, and... the stone buttons, they look kind of cool too. I don't know. The whole idea of the wood block is a little experimental. I don't really know if it works too well. I did try a couple different things. There are so many new blocks that we can try out, so I'm not really, we can definitely manipulate this further, but I do want to kind of work in wood into most of these builds, just because we have such a variety of wood types, and of course they're all readily available here at the beginning of the game. I'm having a little bit of a issue deciding what I'm gonna do for inside here. So I went ahead and made this all water back here. Could have a waterfall coming out of here. That could be kind of cool. Yeah, let's do that. Right in there. There we go. So just like the other cavern that we're working on in our vanilla series, this is just a micro version of that, sort of just a bit of a pain in the behind, because it's, you know, vertical and stuff, and we gotta climb up here and do certain things. But yeah, it's coming along. I dug into the walls, and I think it's looking pretty cool. And I still got to put leaves in here and stuff like that, so we got plenty of stuff to add in here. Also, the vines turn out to be very they're very bright in this biome. I didn't know that was going to be the case. But yeah, I got little waterfalls in here. Yeah, it's kind of cool. And this wood, I think, mixes in really nice. This fir wood is pretty cool, a very cool color. Yeah, and this green, the green willow wood is also an excellent block for in here, at least for our, just because it's got a, definitely we want to have the green overtones and everything. And yeah, it's working out pretty well. It's looking pretty cool in there. That's a little weird. Oh, I wish I had an ender pearl I could just throw up there. So we got the dirt going under there. I don't think I like that. Just the plain dirt right there. Those vines are too bright in this biome. That they don't work the way I thought they were gonna work. They really are very, very bright. That was unexpected. I did not know that's how they looked in this biome. I know we want to take a look at this in the dark. It's definitely lit up now, of course. Yeah, that's looking really good. And of course, I want one out here. I do have to go sleep though, because the mobs are gonna spawn, and that's just gonna be bad news all around. So this looks good here though, right? Yeah, there we go. Floating land. Actually, I'm gonna place that one different. Maybe right there. I did these all in all green colors. I did a couple dark green and a couple light green, but yeah, that's pretty rad. Look at that. I think that's very cool. Is that guy too tall? I think that guy's up too high. Maybe he should be more at eye level. That is cool. That is better. I guess just floating there. And then, yeah, I like him back there in the dirt. I think that's definitely lit up enough. I don't think mobs spawn on lily pads. I don't think that's a thing. So I could plant these somewhere else. But at any rate, I think we're doing pretty good as far as... There we go. That one's... I like that color because it blends in the dark green, but it is lit up pretty nice and blends in real well. These are so bright up here. But yeah, boy, those vines are... Those vines, I think, have got to go. These are just... What did I do right there? Who put vines there like that? I mean, I didn't want it to look like a glow stick, you know, like leaked over everything. That's just bizarre. So anyway, yeah, it's looking pretty good, though, I think. This is looking all right. Yeah, what do you guys think? Now, I know this is... It's not like we have a pathway to get here or anything. It's just this sort of, you know, carved into the space here. But, ooh, I lose a lot of frames. Check out my frame rate. 40 frames a second, I guess, because of the floating lamps. Man, I need a new computer. I do need to do some tweaking on the sides and stuff. I got to get rid of some of that brown dirt up there. But overall, I really like this stuff. This is very, very cool, I think. Just the texture that they created for the living rock is awesome. And the floating flowers, all right, we're starting to look like real wizard botanists here. And this is starting to look like it was populated by elves at some point. I hope you guys had an okay time. And I hope you guys like our little nether portal here, which is not got anything around it. It's just a lonely little nether portal. A little bit of decor and design in the middle of this crazy forest here. I hope you guys have a great couple of days, and I will look forward to seeing you guys in the next episode. Let me know what you guys think, and let me know what's happening. I will see you guys later on. See ya!